Hello and welcome back to Hack Infection and the adventures of Kite and Black Rose in the world. Yes, in the last episode we did a little bit of backtracking, checking out the dungeon we were with Orca at? That didn't make any sense. Yeah, and then at the end of the episode I threw out my money because I didn't read where what I clicked, so we need to make some money, and let's take this field I have in my list. Bursting Pest Over Aqua Field should be level 1 wood indeed. And the B2 dungeon should be there. But before we go to the dungeon, we will clear the field. We will clear the field. Timer start. Oh no, 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 no. Fuck. Did I put in the wrong... Did I put in the wrong field? Shit! I put in the wrong field. not aqua field. Remnant. We want to go into remnant, not aqua field. I'm sorry about that. I fucked that up. Reset timer. Ah, for fucking sake. New keyword. Bursting. Passed over. Remnant. Level 1 fire, okay, need to hack that into my list, and warp! Ooh, dum-dum-dum. So, oh well, we are ready in a fight. Whoa, 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 stop. Stop it! Okay. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, let's get this stuff. We need... Ah, fuck, I forgot. I missed. Didn't I buy? No, I didn't. Fuck, okay, we don't have... those wires to open those, which is bad. So, Twilight Onion, I need to put that in my Twilight Onion. Why? Oh shit, no, it's correct, in Remnant, okay. And we have... Okay, let's then use our Fairy Orb. We have fields here, okay. And now we will use... Oh, we have only one speed charm. We will keep that one for the dungeon, I guess. Why I have this one in my list, but... some other information. That's strange. Hmm. Ah, another information which I can... is those worlds are looping, so if you run in one direction we will come out basically on the other side of the map. Oh, maybe I should... Do we have rep still? Yes, but we don't have an... Oh, whoa, 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 that's not good. That was not good. That was not good. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Do we have a potion? We have a potion. Woo! Which heals 150, which is quite overkill. Woo! Let's use a skill to heal ourselves. Rap! Well, come on! Yay, level up! We need... Well, we can go in the direction of the next portal, and I hope we can use rep before. Okay. so we can heal Black Rose. Up to 70 hit points again. Oh shit. Don't trigger! Don't trigger! Shit. I hate it when the field enemies don't have a portal they come out of and run around the map. So you can be ambushed sometimes. Which is quite annoying. Data drain! But we don't have... Oh, we have enough, okay. A wristband. Ah, yeah, yes. I didn't say that before. You can get items from data drain. And there are cases where you can grind some opponents in order to get certain items. Toilet onion! Yeah, we will need those for grunties later in the game. Quite late in the game. What? I have 11. Let's wrap ourselves. Leap. Okay, and let's move out. We need to get at least one portal, I guess. Or was the message shown that we are opened, everyone? Oh no, there are a few more. Shit. Okay, let's get that over there. And there, again, enemies that aren't on the map. For fucking sake. Well, it's nice we get XP, but... Oh shit, I forgot to start the timer. Whoops. I didn't click right. Well, let's say I put 5 minutes in. Should be okay. Should be okay. So now let me. Okay, in that direction. Okay, we have no fairy fountain. So that one gets zero. That gets a zero. And we didn't found any buffs so far. Die! Protection break! Skill! Ah, this is the gouge that shows you how high the infection is, and at the moment we are below 25%, so it doesn't show anything. Oh. Out of control! Steel blades! Oh, we got a weapon, which is nice. Ah, and when that when the bracelet malfunctions, you get random debuffs on yourself and maybe on your team, depending on how high the infection rate is. And since it's quite low, we only get one effect ourselves. Onion! Twilight onion! Yes. Oh, come on. Another one. At a later point in time, we will use the speed scrolls on the map as well, so we can run faster. But as of now, we can't do that since I wasted all my money. Sadly enough. Okay, all field portals open. That was my goal on this area, because this is one of the milestones you can get in the game by clearing a number of fields. I think 30 or 50 is the limit in the first game, and there are different milestones for different things. There is another milestone for opening all dungeon portals as well. So we will do that. No, I don't want to trade. I just wanted to... Ooh, wrong direction. I want first a speed charm on myself. When you are in a dungeon, you only need to give Kite a speed. speed buff since your party members will get teleported to you once you go through a door. So they will always be by your side. So it is not necessary to buff them as well. Other thing is on the field it's better to buff all of your group members because they can get lost to some degree and then they won't get any XP of the monsters you kill. Another blue one we can't use. Great. But no, we go first in that direction because there's a dead end and with a chest in the next room. We will take that. And we will clear those breakable objects, like those bones there. And as you see, I could see the second skeleton had a potion, which is quite nice. Meteor swarm. I don't know if I said that before, but depending on what type of field you are playing on, the spells get chosen that are collectible in that area. So yes, yellow chest, very nice. So let me heal myself. Reaps. So it wasn't that important to heal myself at this point, but you never know. And now we don't have enough to use the skill. Great. Oh. Yay, level up! Let's go, let's get the sword first. Come, oh, I can't hit him. For fucking sake. Let's use, oh. Why does it hit me when it looks at her? That doesn't make any sense. Ah, fuck, I wanted to data drain it, but I wasn't fast enough to hit the data drain button. Or the menu, better said. Well, let's heal up Black Rose. Reaps! Oh. Okay. And let's head out into the next area. So, if my list is correct, this should be a B2 dungeon, but I think I made an error when I wrote that one down. Come on, I want a data drain. Yes, give me a data drain of that one. Virus core B, yes. I think we need about 6 or 8 in this game. Of those, so a blue one? No, a yellow one. That's nice. That's very nice of you. And let's go down there first. And it's going further down. And yes, it's skills. Did I data drain the knife? I don't think so. Iron spear! Kill him! Oh, I only get 28 XP now. That's shitty. That's shitty! The difference in XP you get depends on how the difference between you and the monster you killed is. So, and 28 means, let me open up the right file. And 28. There's a difference of 4 between me and the monster I killed. Reeps! So yeah. If the difference gets higher, you will get lower XP to the point where you only get 1 XP per opponent you kill. Which is to some point really annoying, because in this game, oh fuck, in this game the limit is 99, also I mean level 99, and each level takes the same amount of XP, 1000. Come on, kill him. Did you get him? Yes, 1000 XP. So yeah. Well, the shitty part is that the highest level opponent is level 30. So that means if you are level 40, you will only get 1 XP, and every level after that you will get only 1 XP per opponent. So basically, once you reached level 40, you need to kill 59,000 opponents in order to get to maximum level. But no worries, we will get there. We will get there. That's something I can... well, what's the word? Promise. Well, I say promise, but I don't know if we get there. Because it will take quite a while to kill 59,000 enemies. Even though if we can one-hit them at some point in the future, it still takes some time. But the game will get easier the higher we are. So, well, I can explain that, because with each level up you get more HP, hit points, and SP, that are the points you need to use skills, so skill points. Yeah, and that those are basically the important stats you only need to think about in this game. No, not here. I want to cast Rep on myself. There are stats on literally every item, and I talk about that after we finished this dungeon. Shit, and our scroll just ended. Oh no! Now we need to run with slow speed. That's annoying. Well, but we need to live with that for a while, since I wasted all the money! So annoying. Okay, next fairy orb. Okay, I did note. Oh, for fucking sake. I wrote down this is a B2 dungeon, but it's actually not, since we can see another downstairs area on the minimap. Oh, that was a new opponent. I should have data drained him. Too bad. Too bad. Okay, let's open the chest. And another hanged man, and another chest. Great. And another hanged man. As of now, I won't use those spells, because for these opponents it is not necessary to waste those scrolls, because you can't buy those scrolls, those certain scrolls. you can get them only from opponents, chests, or destructible objects. There are spells, there are spells like those speed scrolls that you can buy, but not those like the Hanged Man and that stuff. So this is quite annoying. Phantom Twin! Oh, that's a weapon for me, I think. Die, Shine! Let's have a look. Equipment. Yeah, Phantom Twin. Does give us more attack damage and accuracy, which is nice. That means we can sell our weapon, which gives us a bit of more money we can work with. Well, I could sell those spells, but there are quite a few fights where you want to use spells because they are more efficient than your auto attack or skill attacks. There is a very, not very interesting, but an interesting element system in this game. So basically, I don't know if I already told you guys that, but let's take the example. Our opponent is a, I think I told that one, is a water elemental, or off the water element. You can do high or double damage with the use of a fire spell, because fire evaporates water. Well, it has some kind of logic, but if the roles are reversed, if that if we hit a fire elemental with a water spell, we will what's the word for, oh shit, for, well, we will clear out the fire. That doesn't make any sense, do it, does it? Ah, I don't know the English word. What's the word? Extinguish. Water extinguishes fire, so if you use a water spell on a fire based opponent, fire elemental, he will get double damage from the water spell, which is well, it makes sense to some degree, but compared to other games, you wouldn't have water beats fire and fire beats water. You would have, for example, like in Pokemon, you have water beats stone and stone beats I think normal and whatnot, and you don't have that those direct direct things like you have in this game. So those X that we are looted quite a few now are also grunty food, which we will use at a later time, as I said before. So, three more fights in this level, on this level. Let's data drain our next opponent in order to get some more virus cores. Data drain! Oh, I totally forgot about that. Normally there would be a little animation happening when you use data drain, but it's always the same. The only difference is that you see the opponent gets data drained, and it's unnecessary, so I deactivated that one. So we don't waste any time, because you can't do anything in that animation, and I think it's up to 10 seconds, maybe only 6 seconds, but viewing that animation every time you use data drain is, oh, it gets boring. And yeah, the game itself is really slow paced, so I don't want to extend it any more than it is necessary. That's why we need to get money, so that we can buy those sweet scrolls and don't need to run through the dungeons at the snail's pace. Yeah. It's highly likely we would be already done with this dungeon if we had more scrolls. More sweet scrolls, that is. Yay! We got our first 10 data drains, so we get the first Ryubook 1. Yeah, we will check that out when we completed this dungeon. And I just had a little look at the recording timer and this episode will get longer than the other ones, so please bear with me. There will be some episodes that will be even longer. In my trial runs I had a dungeon that took 72 minutes, so well, not a dungeon alone. The field area, the overworld, so to speak, alone took 20 minutes to clear, and then the dungeon for the rest 52 minutes. Yeah. So there will be some quite long episodes coming. Ah, yes. I need to talk about that as well. As I probably mentioned in the first episode or not. No! What did I do? I'm a retard. I used the wrong item. Oh no. For fucking sake. For fucking sake. And now we have a big problem. Shit. We have a very big problem now. The dungeon is reset. Ah! Fuck. That is not good. Well, we will now rush, as fast as we can go to the last level and clear the god statue at the end. Because I fucked up again, which is quite annoying. I wanted to use a fairy orb, not a teleport out. And that's why we won't loot all that stuff. We will go on to the next level. Because the episode is long enough already and we don't need to do everything again. Even though I need the experience. So, yeah, where was I before I fucked up? I think I mentioned it, but I doubt I did, so I planned on doing it, but I will do now. There will be two kinds of episodes in this series, and you can see what kind of episode it will be in the name of the episode. There will be two pairs of rectangular brackets. At the start of the video name, the first will be point H, which is this is just for me for organizing my videos, and it stands for .hack obviously, and yeah, you don't need to worry about that. What is important, so to say, for you is the second pair of rectangular brackets. And in those brackets you will either see an S for story or a G for grind. So let me explain that a little bit further. Story episodes will have either story or bonus events like that goblin race, which I count as story. even though it is a side story, those events. But to me, I count it as a story. So the other one is Grind, G for Grind, and this is basically one of those episodes, the first one. And the majority of the series will be Grind episodes, for reasons I will tell you in the future. And as of now, we are concentrating on doing a little bit of grinding, but mostly want to do the main story until the point we can kill the final boss. And before we can do that, or before we will do that, we will grind the shit out of this game. We will grind at least to, let's say, level 40 or so. So that will will take quite some time. In my trial run of this game, I think it took around 23 hours to get to level 36. So yeah, that will be quite a few episodes of grinding. So, and the reason is, why do I for me to split those, because grinding episodes will be extremely boring, since there will be nothing happening except for me fighting opponents on the field and fighting opponents in the dungeons, running back and forth, selling items, equipping items, and yeah, it's quite repetitive. But I still want to record every field that there is. Well, now I spoiled the surprise. Well, yeah, that's basically my goal for the series, to visit every 22,736 fields, which will take, if you do... Well, we can do a little bit of math there. In a second, let me open up the right document. So, if you take 10 minutes per zone, which we are not at the pace currently, if you take 10 minutes per zone, you would need 158 days in playing time if you played straight through in order to visit all fields. So that's highly unlikely. So I started my spreadsheet basically and add a data in of the runs I currently do and did in my trial run. And that is a more realistic time, and that is at the moment at 354 days to visit all fields. So, as you probably can imagine, that I can't play the game for 554 days straight. That's quite impossible for one person to do. So, I'm currently thinking about maybe depending on how much time I have, if I can do 10 fields a day, which would be quite much. It would take, let me calculate it, it's 3,650 per year if I do that every day. And yeah, it takes 10 years, not 10 years, about 8 years would it, well, it would take about 7 to 8 years if I played 10 maps each day. So you see, it's a quite ambiguous project I have there. and it is very likely that I will never finish it, but we won't go there yet. But think about it. 10 fields a day, 7 to 8 years, it's quite much time. for one game to spend time on. so ridiculous. So ridiculous. But at some point we will get fast enough, and I guess the time will go down. The average load my timetable is 22 minutes and around 40 seconds on the data I have compiled so far. So that would be, let me go back to the other table. Let's say I'm around 20 minutes per zone. That will take 316 days playtime to clear. So it's still a big chunk, but it's less than 354. Well, I hope that we will get down to 15 minutes per zone sometime in the future. So it will only take 237 days. Which is, if I think about it, it's still much. It's still quite much to do there. Oh fuck, and did you... Oh, there's another level, level 4. For fucking sake. Shit, this episode will be longer. We are right now at 36 minutes and 11 seconds. 13 seconds? 15 seconds? Yeah. It takes longer than I expected, because I thought I cleared this field. I had this one already in my table. But surely I messed up there somewhere. I don't know what happened there. Otherwise I wouldn't have chosen this area, because the area I wanted to had only two levels in the dungeon. This can be have five if we are totally unlucky. Well, it's not so unlucky, but because we get quite some big amount of XP, but still. The episode takes way longer than I anticipated it would. Ooh, yeah, and basically I don't have much to talk about while we are on those grind episodes, since there is just so much you can talk about this game. And now we don't have any more fairy ocarinas. Not fairy ocarinas, what's the word? We don't have any more items that clear the map, so we now need to go through each room and hope that we find the right way the first time and get to the god statue at the end. Ay caramba. Oh shit, I could have data drained that one. Because I think I didn't data drain those plants before. Yeah. Well, yeah, now you know my crazy plan. Oh yeah, let's go back back to the two types of episodes. So I don't know yet how I will release them, but I guess I will release several episodes per day, so you can basically skip all of the grind episodes and just watch the story episodes. So yeah, if you are just interested in the story episodes, It's understandable that you don't want to watch all that grindy stuff, because nothing really happened there. Okay, which way? Let's go that way. Yeah. Oh, a new opponent. Let's data drain that one. Mitsuhi. That could be a sword, I guess. Let's get the egg. Let's check it. What did we get? Oh, something for our dear companion. Hello! I've got a sword for you. Received. What? Do you have a better sword already? Did I give... Have I given her a better sword already? I don't... I given her a helmet. But a weapon? Ah, and the god statue! Oh, great. Hands of Earth, Mage Soul, Gruntor. Okay, let's check that one out. Where are those? Hands of Earth, level 13. We can't use that, Long Arm can't use it, and Wavemaster can't use it, but our Black Rose can use it, but yeah, it's level 13, so she can't equip it right now. That's why we won't give it to her yet, because she will most likely sell it to the vendor. So now I use the right thing. Fuck, so annoying that I wasted so much time. So, timer stop. Oh, shit, and now we can't teleport back to city because we are in fight again. Okay. Oh, yellow chest. We take that one with us. Another spell. And another chest. Woo! No, 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 no. Okay, the death. Okay. Gate out now. Okay. Let's say 35 minutes for this one, and it was a B4. Why is there a B2 there? It's a B4. 35 minutes and a few seconds. Okay. Let's remove that one. Okay. Yeah, let's end the episode here, and let me check up on my data. I need to check why this field was wrongly in that list, yeah, and figure out where the error is. So thank you for watching if you stayed until the end, and until next time, bye peace.